As you have seen, that this seminar here is kind of hand over the leadership of our Center for Indoor Environment and Energy. But just so you know, it's not a retirement from my side. It's just having younger people coming into the picture. And talking about younger and older, it's very important to know a little about your roots. So I just want to put up a couple of information on how this year started and what how far we go back. And we really go back from when we had the laboratory of heating, ventilation, and started more than 80 years ago. And now we are up to the International Center for Indoor Environment. We celebrated a couple of years ago, 7 years ago, 125 years for the first independent chair of heating and ventilation. No, almost the first. The first independent chair was 1 week earlier at the Technical University in Berlin. So that were two of the first places in the world where we had teaching of heating and ventilation as a chair alone who had this topic. And then the laboratory where we also started looking at research was then established some 80 years ago. You can probably find our homepage. We have made a whole history if you want to know more about this history. The center was started in 98, where we got a major research budget from a government research fund, this time called STVF. And that also included money so we could hire people, but also extend our research facilities. So here is from the inauguration of our new environmental chambers, which most of you know or have seen, from 2001. Now, as I mentioned, the Laboratory of Heating and Ventilation was established in 1935. At that time, DTU was organized in a different way. Then it was changed to Laboratory of Heating and Air Conditioning later on. So we were part of this section for indoor environment energy then started in 96-98, where we had this 10 years project. So that was very fortunate to have a 10-year project where you had money both to develop new research facility and also increase the research staff. So that was the initiation of the Center for Indoor Environment and Energy. So when we now look at some of the metrics for what we have been done and how successful, I have here looked a little at our external funding. I started 2008 because that was the year where the funding for the big 10 years project stopped. In fact, the last 5 years of that, we had a reduced budget every year. But you can see from the funding here in a million Danish kroners, we have been able to keep, I think, on an average somewhere between 8 and 10 million Danish kroner per year for research. And that's for all different types of funds. But you can also see it varies from year to year. So it's very important that we work as a group and support each other, because when you get the funding, you don't have a really control that you get exactly the same amount every year. Well, this research has to turn into publication, and that's another thing where we have been very good at that dissemination of the research we have done, both through papers And here you can see some of the ISI index publications we have had over the year. And when we now look at our citations, because we have more and more papers, so the number of citations also increases. So when we look then, the final one. No, I had one with the total publications, because we are not only putting publications into ISI, we also do a lot of conference publications. And I think on average, we have about 60, 70 publications a year from the center. So that just shows you how much we are out there and disseminate our results. And this is very important that this continue. This is also what has made us known in the world, that our research results are coming out, being used in standards and also being used by industry. And you will now, the rest of the day, hear some of the research that is ongoing at the moment. Thank you.